Hello everyone, myself Prayag Patel, working as an assistant professor in IT-ICT department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Now in today's video lecture, I will discuss about the master's method of the divide and conquer algorithm unit. Now we already solved the sum method for solve the recurrence equation. First one is forward substitution method, second one is backward substitution method. Now third method consider as a master's method for solve the recurrence equation. Now first understand what is the master's method for solve the recurrence equation. Here consider the master's method is a cookbook method for solve the recurrence equation. Suppose you have a recurrence relation in form of T of n equal to a t n by b plus f of n, then you can apply the master's method for solve the recurrence equation. Means if the given relation in form of T of n equal to a t n by b plus f of n, then you can apply the master's method here. Now what is the value of a n by b or f of n? We understand one by one. Now first, what is the value of a? A means number of subproblems, means T of n as a whole problem. Then we divide the problem into many subproblems. Then how many number of subproblems are available is considered as a value of a. So a considered as a number of subproblems. Now T of n by b, what is the meaning of T of n by b? T of n by b means we can consider time required to solve a subproblem. So if we consider the subproblem, then how many time required for solve the particular subproblem is considered as a time required for solving the subproblem is T of n by b. Now third part is plus f of n. Now what is the f of n? F of n means time to divide and recombine the problem. Means originally problem considered as a size n. Then we divide this problem into n by 2 form. Then how many number of problem are there? It's considered as a. Then time required to solve the subproblem as a T of n by b. And time required for divide the problem and then recombine this problem solution is considered as a f of n. This recurrence would arise in the analysis of recursive algorithm. When input size n is larger, then the problem is divided up to the a subproblems each of size n by b. Subproblems are solved recursively and result are recombined, and therefore result recombine and divide process is considered as a time f of n. Now consider the equation for the master's method. Consider the following recurrence relation T of n equal to a t n by b plus f of n. For this consider f of n is a theta n raised to t, where d greater or equal to 0, means value of d consider as a 0, 1, 2, 3 like this. A greater or equal to 1 means value of a consider as a 1 or greater than 1. B greater or equal to 2 means consider the value of b as a 2, 3, 4 like this in the recurrence relation. Then consider this three formula for find the solution of the master's method example. T of n equal to theta n raised to d if a less than b raised to d is considered as a first equation, means case number 1. Second, T of n equal to theta n raised to d log n if a equal to b raised to d, means simply we can compare a with b raised to d. If a less than b raised to d, then consider as a case 1, theta of n raised to d. If a equal to b raised to d, then consider case 2, theta of n raised to d log n. And third, T of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b if a greater than b raised to d, this is considered as a case number 3. So these three equation used for solve the master's method example. Now consider these three equation and solve the example using the master's method. Example number 1, T of n equal to 16 t n by 4 plus 5 n cube. Now what is the value of a, what is the value of b? For that we compare T of n given equation with the T of n equal to a t n by b plus f of n. So here consider f of n as a theta of n raised to d, a equal to 16 because 16 t n by 4 is given data, so a equal to 16. b equal to 4. What is the value of t? Here in the form of function f of n consider as a 5n cube. In function f of n, what is the n raised to t? Power of n consider as a value of d. So here d equal to 3. Now compare a with b raised to t. If a equal to b raised to t, a less than b raised to d, or a greater than b raised to t. And according to this three case, we apply the particular equation according to our condition. So here consider 16 as a a, b raised to d means 4 raised to 3 consider as a b raised to d. So here 4 raised to 3, 16 is less than 4 raised to 3. So here consider the case number 1 is applicable. So consider the case number 1, a less than b raised to d. Then t of n equal to theta n raised to t. Now put the value of t into this equation, theta n raised to t, d equal to 3. So theta of n raised to 3. So our complexity is considered as a theta of n raised to 3, means n cube as our complexity for the given recurrence relation, t of n equal to 16t n by 4 plus 5n cube. So this is a solution of the our first example. Now consider the another example for the master's method. Example number 2, t of n equal to 2t n by 2 plus n. Now consider the recurrence relation as a t of n equal to at n by b plus f of n, and find the value of a, b and d. Consider the f of n as a theta of n raised to d. So a equal to 2, b equal to 2 and d equal to 1, because here f of n is a n, so n raised to 1, so d equal to 1. Now compare the a with the b raised to d. So here a equal to 2, b raised to d means b raised to 2 raised to 1 consider as a b raised to d. So 2 equal to 2 condition is satisfied, a equal to b raised to d. That's why we consider the second case, case number 2. According to case number 2, t of n equal to theta n raised to d log n. Now put the value of t. So here d equal to 1, so our final answer is theta n raised to 1 log n, and n raised to 1 means n. So we can consider complexity for the given example is theta n log n. Now consider the third example using the master's method. So t of n equal to 8t n by 2 plus n. Now what is the value of a, b and d? So here a equal to 8, b equal to 2 and d equal to n raised to t. So d equal to 1, n raised to 1 as a d equal to 1. So compare the condition a equal to b raised to d, a less than b raised to d and a greater than b raised to d. So here 8 is greater than 2 raised to 1. So a greater than b raised to d condition is satisfied. So apply the case number 3, t of n equal to theta of n raised to log a base b according to case number 3 equation. So here put the value of a and b in the place of log a base b. So theta of n raised to log 8 base 2. Now 8 consider as a 2 raised to 3. So we can consider log 2 base 2 raised to 3. So log 2 base 2 consider as a value 1. So our answer is theta of n cube. So final complexity of the example number 3, t of n equal to 8t n by 2 plus n equal to theta of n cube. So this is a complexity of our example. Now some variation in master's method. We already see the three equation, previous three equation consider as a normal equation of the master's method. Now consider the another some equations for the variation of the master's method. Here in variation in master's method also required the same relation, t of n equal to at n by b plus f of n. Now consider the recurrence equation for the variation of master's method. First one is, if f of n equal to big O of n raised to log a base b minus epsilon for some condition epsilon greater than 0, then t of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b. Means here we consider given value compare with the log a base b. Means f of n compare with the log a base b. If the f of n value and n raised to log a base b value is greater than f of n, then subtract something from the f n raised to log a base b. So that's why we consider the minus epsilon. Second equation, if f of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b, then t of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b log n. Third equation, if f of n equal to omega n raised to log a base b plus epsilon for some constant epsilon greater than 0, then t of n equal to theta f of n. Here we compare f of n with the n raised to log a base b. And according to this, we consider the three cases. First case, if f of n less or equal to n raised to log a base b, then apply the first case or first equation. If f of n equal to n raised to log a base b, if the both value of f of n and n raised to log a base b are equal, then consider the second case and apply the equation number 2. Third case, f of n greater or equal to n raised to log a base b, then apply the case number 3, equation number 3. So according to these three cases, we find the value of master's method example. Now for the this, consider the case 1, 2 and 3 equation. Same equation are there. First, f of n less or equal to n raised to log a base b, then t of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b. Case number 2, if f of n equal to n raised to log a base b, then t of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b into log n. Third equation, case number 3, f of n greater or equal to n raised to log a base b, then t of n equal to theta of f of n. So here our aim is find the value of t of n. Now consider the one example for find the solution of the master's method using variation of master's method technique. T of n equal to 2t n by 2 plus n. Now what is the value of a, b? So here consider the value of a equal to 2, b equal to 2. Now find the value of f of n and compare the value of f of n with the n raised to log a base b. So first find the n raised to log a base b. N raised to log a base b. So n raised to log 2 base 2 equal to 1. So only n consider as our answer. Now next consider f of n equal to which value? N. So here n raised to log a base b equal to n, and f of n also consider as a n. So compare f of n and log n raised to log a base b is considered as a n equal to n. Means both they are equal. So consider the case number 2 or apply the case number 2. In case number 2, what is the equation of t of n? T of n equal to theta n raised to log a base b log n. So here consider this equation for the case number 2, and according to this, here theta n raised to log 2 base 2 log n. So here log 2 base 2 consider as a 1. So theta n log n is our answer for the given example. So according to normal method as well as variation in master's method equation, you can find the solution of the example. Now consider the second example, t of n equal to t n by 2 plus theta of 1. Now here what is the value of a, b? So here a equal to 1 because only t of n by 2 is given, b equal to 2. Now find the n raised to log a base b. So n raised to log 1 base 2, log 1 base 2 consider as a 0, so n raised to 0 equal to 1. So n raised to log a base b value equal to 1. Now what is the value of function f of n? F of n equal to theta of 1. So theta of 1 means constant value as a 1. So here consider first value as a 1, second value as a 1. So both the value are equal. So we consider case number 2. Apply the case number 2 according to our equation. So in case number 2, t of n equal to, equation is theta n raised to log a base b into log n. So this is our equation. According to this equation, we find the value, and value is considered as a log 1 base 1, and here consider the log 2 base 1 equal to 0. So here n term is considered as a 0. So only log n term is remaining. So our final complexity, t of n equal to theta log n. Now third example, t of n equal to 4t n by 2 plus n. Here what is the value of a? A equal to 4, b equal to 2. Now find the log a base b. So log a base b means here consider the value as a log 4 base 2. So here log 4 base 2 consider as a value or answer as a n square. Now what is the function f of n? F of n equal to n. So compare these two value, log n, n raised to log a base b and f of n. So here first value is n square, second value is n. So f of n less or equal to n square condition is satisfied, means consider the case number 1 And according to case number 1, t of n equal to theta, n raised to log a base b. Now what is the value of n raised to log a base b? Value of n raised to log a base b equal to n square. So here theta of n square is our final answer for the given example. Now consider the example number 4 for the variation of Master's method. T of n equal to 2t n by 2 plus n log n is a given equation. Now what is the value of a, b? A equal to 2, also b equal to 2. Now find the log a base b, means log 2 base 2 equal to 1. Now consider the function f of n. F of n equal to n log n. Now compare f of n with the n log n. So f of n equal to n log n, and n raised to log a base b equal to n. So here compare these two and consider the case number 3, because here f of n is greater than or equal to n raised to log a base b. So t of n equal to theta of f of n according to equation number 3. Now what is the f of n? F of n means n log n. So simply we put the n log n in form of f of n. So final complexity is theta n log n. Now consider the last example for the Master's method or variation of Master's method. T of n equal to 3t n by 4 plus n log n. Now a equal to 3, b equal to 4, f of n equal to n log n. Now find the log a base b value. Here consider the log a base b means log a means 3, b means 4. So log 3 base 4, and value of the log 3 base 4 equal to 0.793. So n raised to log a base b means n raised to 0.793. Now what is the value of function f of n? F of n equal to n log n. So in this case we consider the third case, case number 3. F of n is greater than or equal to n raised to log a base b. According to this, t of n equal to theta of f of n, and f of n equal to n log n. That's why here our answer is theta of n log n for the equation t of n equal to 3t n by 4 plus n log n. So this is a variation of Master's method, and according to variation of Master's method you can find the solution of the any recurrence relation. So in today's video lecture I discuss about the variation of Master's method as well as the simple Master's method. Using Master's method you can find the solution of the recurrence relation or recurrence equation. Thank you for watching.